Hey there, let's talk about the elements of the criminal justice system. You'll see here that there are three main elements. We have law enforcement, judicial, and corrections. And if you have a difficult time remembering those, think about the three C's: cops, courts, corrections. Now, the goal of law enforcement is to control and prevent crime. Sounds pretty simple. But law enforcement derives that authority to do so from the laws that legislatures write and adopt. Then the purpose of the courts is to take those laws and interpret them and apply them to various cases that come before them. Then, when somebody is found guilty of a crime and they're sentenced by either a judge or a jury, corrections takes over. And the role of corrections is custody, control, supervision, security, and rehabilitation of the people that come into their facilities and their programs. Now, here's the thing with law enforcement, judiciary, and corrections. Sometimes they work together and sometimes they're in conflict, and that's not a bad thing. But let's talk about the ways that they cooperate first. So they all work together to hold offenders accountable for breaking the law. Law enforcement will make the arrest. They'll document all of the evidence and collect it. And that could be in the form of physical evidence that's there at the crime scene or a physical evidence that's been taken somewhere else. It could be photographs or video recordings. It can also include statements made by any witnesses, the victim, and sometimes the offender themselves. They look at all of this evidence and they make sure that they have met every element of a crime prior to charging this person. And when they've met every element of the crime, they have enough probable cause. That's a burden of proof required to arrest or prosecute somebody. So they have enough probable cause to take this to a prosecutor, and then the prosecutor can bring it to the court. Now, our system in our country is adversarial in nature. This means that we have two sides pitted against each other. One side is the prosecutor's office, and they represent the locality or jurisdiction in which a crime was committed. The other side is the defense attorney, and they represent the person who is accused. Both will put on their own evidence in hopes of winning. The judge is there to make sure that the rules of the court are followed, that the law is applied fairly and appropriately. And the jury is there, if there is a jury, and we'll talk more about that later in the year. The jury is there to hear the evidence as well, and either the judge or the jury will come to a determination on guilt. Once they have done that, the judge or the jury can also then determine a sentence for the person who has been convicted of the crime. Then corrections takes over and they oversee the implementation of the sentencing that the judge or the jury decided upon. Now, here's where it comes into conflict sometimes. The judiciary is supposed to be unbiased, and so at times that means that they're going to rule in favor of the defendant. Even sometimes when that person has committed a crime, and that's because it's also the judiciary's responsibility to uphold and protect the constitutional rights of citizens. So, if law enforcement is found to have violated the rights of a citizen, they may find themselves in conflict with the court's decision. Additionally, all of these people who are involved in the court process, law enforcement, prosecutors, defense attorneys, judges, and juries, they might be in conflict amongst themselves with sentencing, such as plea bargaining, lenient versus harsh sentencing, and the method of punishment versus rehabilitation. So, if you have any questions or concerns about the elements of the criminal justice system, be sure to go back and review this slideshow. Bye for now.